All right, there's a keeper, you guys. Up underneath that overhang. First one today, and we'll put him back in the water real fast so we can get rid of him. All right. Maybe we can fish this main river. I've caught him like this before. Down here this time of year. Gonna find out. Keeper, guys, it's a little hole that I was catching good in practice. I mean, not practice, but during guiding. But hopefully, we just got in here. Hopefully, we can get a couple more. There's nobody else in here. Good, clean, healthy fish. But just see, it's been tough. I mean, it's been real tough. Hey guys, you know, it's been a tough practice, like I said. This is one of the places I've been catching them while I was doing my guide trips and stuff. We came back in here, I caught one, just a keeper, and then I had two more hit that jackhammer and missed it. I had them hold for a second to come off, and then I put on a swim bait and had one hit it. And what I'm doing right now is I'm just kind of throwing, because I know they'll hit that jackhammer, which I knew that before I come in here, but I didn't know if these fish were still being here, if they've been banged up too much, because there's so many boats out here for fishing this tournament and just fishing the lake. But so what I'm doing is going through some different baits, you know, this all hydrilla underneath here, this whole base full of hydrilla. So what I'm doing is I'm going through and trying some other baits right now to see if I can get some reaction strikes, just like when I switched over to that swim bait. I didn't know if they would hit a swim bait. I've been catching some here on MagDraft, and I knew they'd hit that, but I put a smaller swim bait on. I had a hit on that. So what I'm trying to do is figure out, now since I got a group of fish I know I can fish for, what will they hit? And I'm trying to mess around right now to see what I can get these fish to hit. That way, to come tournament day, I don't waste time throwing stuff that I'm not for sure. Because, you know, if you come in here, if it's tough to get a limit each day, if I stay in here and get, and work this creek over, I feel pretty confident I get a limit out each day, even if I got to really fish it really hard, because I know there's a school of fish in here. But I want to know when I come back in the tournament what I can and can't fish. So anytime you're practicing for a tournament, you guys, no matter how big or how small, keep this in mind. If you get on a school of fish, you don't want to go around there and stick a bunch of them. You may want to throw some other baits and stuff to see what you can get strikes on, even if it means cutting the hooks and stuff off of them. You just want to get bites. You want to see if they'll react on those baits. That'll help you do better in the tournament. Like I say, this is going to be a tough tournament. The fish are just not wanting to jump up right now and eat. They're just in that mood. It's not going to be long until these fish are going to jump up. We got a bunch of carp jumping around now, but as things are starting to happen, carp and gars moving in. I think the majority of our fish, it ain't long until they spawn. I don't know if it's going to hit during this tournament. We need some water, and we don't really have the rain and forecast to get it. So we got to deal fish with what we got. But anyways, guys, like I said, if you find a school of fish to practice for a tournament, you can use your practice to find out what baits that they react on, okay? Again, even if it means cutting the hooks off of them, because you don't want to stick them, you just know if that one of them hit that bait. All right, guys, this is the tip I want to pass on to you. I'm going to keep fishing a little bit. That's what I'm talking about. Or they could just, things can change overnight this time of year. You gotta be ready for that in case it does. You can go back in a creek and catch them, and not catch them. In a day or two, they're gonna be full of fish just because they're migrating and it's just that time of year. I think it's a big old carp. I don't know if I'm gonna get my bait back or not. If only it was a 10-pound largemouth. I got him hooked in the back too, so he'll run forever. Look at her, honey. What you got right here by you?
The camera is still.
Here.
Oh, I thought it's a 10-pounder bass.
I did too. I was hoping. You guys, that's on a PAL diesel rod, guys. I'm thinking, well, this is a good strong rod. I don't know how long we've been fighting this guy. She put a lot of pressure. She's about tired, don't you think?
Yeah.
Because I give up.
I give up.
You want to touch her?
I'm afraid.
Just touch her. Don't get by the lure.
I'm scared.
Okay. All right, well, I'm going to get my lure out then. Anytime you're fighting a fish like this, you guys, you got to watch that lure because it's loaded. Now. She's worn out now. There she goes. All right. Well, that was exciting. A little bit of fun. But anyways, like I said, that was a PAL diesel rod, you guys. These are $100 rods. So there's probably a 15-pound carp that I hooked in the back. And anytime you hook one in the back, like, they go crazy. But I'm finding that thing, great rod for the money right there, you guys. I'm telling you. Fish really well. All right, let's try to catch some bass now.